Hey guys, Devin here from Racing Hotspot. Welcome to this week's show. It's April. It is June 27th, I believe. Hold on. Dang it. Yep, June 27th, 2017. I'm going to be your host this for the show, Devin Poslusny. Dave won't be alongside me today. Neither will the Godfather, unfortunately, due to some other issues that they had. Now, I'm in the studio. Okay, I'm in the room that was formerly our studio, which, as you can see, is getting pulled apart. And I know most of you guys are watching this going, whoa, 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 what? Let me explain. So, we unfortunately had to get moved. The people, or my parents, wanted to move me and my uncle to another part of the house, which is actually just upstairs, literally directly above us. So with that being said, we had to break down everything and move it upstairs. So don't worry, Racing Hotspot's still here to stay, but we are ending a 6-year run in this room to move up into a new area. So Dave and I are looking forward to this. Actually, I don't even know if Dave's aware of it. But we got a lot of work ahead of us. I just moved 3 totes upstairs. I still have to rearrange the lighting up there. So we got a lot of work. But hopefully, everything will be put back into place by the time we get back from July race weekend at NHMS in 2 weeks. All right. So it's been a great 6 years in this room, as you can see. We got the old-fashioned light as the studio lights are off and are getting ready to be packed up. So a lot of packing up, a lot of wiring that needs to be pulled up, and my parents are planning on taking all this down, so it's kind of bittersweet. But it's been a great 6 years in this room. Let's start a new chapter of Racing Hotspot in our brand-new studio with this week's show. Recapping all this, the weekend's racing of NASCAR, IndyCar, Formula One, NHRA, and motocross. So, let's start the show. June 27th, 2017. Once again, I'm your host Devin Poslusny, alongside Miss Kaylin. and as we already said in our little intro, we moved, and this is what the new studio looks like. It might take some tweaking. There might be some things that change on here, but for the most part, this is what the new studio will look like. And yeah. One of the things we did want to change, before we get into the show lineup and all that stuff, one of the things we did want to change was the height of the TV screens, which we were able to do. We moved them up, so Dave and I will now fit right underneath where, like, when we have Peter Long on, we'll be clear. So, it's pretty exciting, excuse me. So, let's look at the show lineup here. We got a rapid recap, then we'll go to motocross, then we'll go to IndyCar, we'll take a break. We'll talk Formula One, NASCAR, and the final lap. This is going well. Rapid recap. The topics are on the board there. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Tell you the type of month we've been having. So, one other thing I do want to say. This is the first time in 2 weeks, 3 weeks that we're back. And the last 3 weeks have consisted of my finals for school, which I passed all classes. And as well as Dave was away still. And it was just a laundry list of things that went wrong. But we're back now. We're here. And hopefully, as I said with the new studio, we're building. We're making it good. As I'm looking at the screen in front of the camera right now going, are we too dark? So we'll figure it out. We'll figure out everything. And we'll get it all down. Hopefully, as I said in the pre to this, by the time we get back from July race weekend, in 2 weeks, we'll be all set. So let's go. Rapid recap. Let's try and do this in 60. 60 seconds. Starts now. NHRA ran this past weekend. Here's the top winners from the top three classes. Bo Buckner got Pro Stock, Jack Beckman got Funny Car, and Steve Torrance got the Top Fuel. Motocross ran this past weekend as well. Here's the 250 Supercross, or Motocross, results. Aaron Plessinger got the win, followed by Zach Osborne and Austin Forkner. 450 had Eli Tomac, Jason Anderson, and Blake Baggett. Tomac getting the overall win. IndyCar was this past weekend in Wisconsin. Scott Dixon got the overall win. Joseph Newgarden got second, and Helio Castroneves got third. Formula One had Daniel Ricciardo get the ultimate win, followed by Valtteri Bottas and Lance Stroll. NASCAR was in different spots. The Cups were in Sonoma, and the Truck and Xfinity was in. Guess I couldn't do it at 60.
In the book. Right there. It's up on the TV.
It's all good. The Xfinity and Truck Series were running in Iowa. Please stay on topic. Anyways, Trucks, John Hunter Nemechek got the win, followed by Johnny Sauter and Brandon Jones. And William Byron got the ultimate win, followed by Ryan Siege and Tyler Reddick. In the Cup Series, Kevin Harvick got the win, followed by Clint Bowyer and Brad Keselowski. Babbling. So let's go. Moving on now. Alright, moving on now, sorry. Like I said, new studio, new tech, new equipment, trying to work it out. And new tenants. Motocross, 250, Wild Moto 1 for Jeremy Martin, he went down. There's a crazy start in 250 Moto 2. 450, great battle for the lead in Moto 1. Anderson versus Barcia, and 450 Baggett had a great recovery in Moto 2. Moving on to IndyCar here. Castroneves got the win, the pole on Sunday. He led him to the green. Takuma Sato, your Indy 500 champion this year, had issues on lap 29. He spun out in one of the fastest parts of the racetrack. On the restart, Scott Dixon got the lead, and then Will Power, James Hinchcliffe ran into each other, causing an accident. And then Rossi versus Kanaan, they were going at it for a couple corners and a straightaway or two, and they finally, Kanaan ended up in the wall. Moving on here to Formula One. Normally we would have, Peter Long on right about now, but unfortunately he was unable to make it to this week's show. They were in Azerbaijan, basically the newest course on the circuit, and also one of the tightest. Let me tell you, it is poof. So insane start, so many accidents. There were multiple collisions, contacts. It was insane. Valtteri Bottas had an issue on lap one, got into somebody, causing a wing issue, had to go to the back. Hamilton versus Vettel, I'm going to come back to that. Red Bull had an extremely good weekend all around. Force India, the two teammates there collided with each other, causing them to end their days. Hamilton had issues. Vettel gets a penalty. And then last lap pass, Valtteri Bottas got around Lance Stroll. What?
Is it okay I go under the table?
No, stay on.
I'm tired. I wanna take a nap.
We're almost done though, I promise. Hamilton versus Bottas. Now, Vettel. So this was under caution. Full course yellow, full safety car. They were behind the pace car, or safety car. Hamilton reported in saying the safety car's got to pick up their speed. They're really going slow. And on the restart, Hamilton slowed down, causing Vettel to hit him. And then Vettel came alongside of him, gave him a bird, and then rammed into the side of him. And from Hamilton's point of view, Vettel came up, hit him intentionally. From Vettel's point of view, Hamilton brake checked him, and Vettel was just retaliating. So Vettel got a penalty for that. Hamilton had an issue with a pit road issue. So last lap pass, they just Bottas got around Lance Stroll. Done the last couple of laps here. So, folks, I do apologize for the lack of woo in this show. It's just been...
Wait, stop! I'm going party.
Okay. It's just been
don't
one...
Don't go without me! I don't want you to talk to go.
Down
there.
Okay.
Okay. See you later. See you tomorrow. Hi, Daddy.
Anyways, things have just been crazy. A week ago, we were still in our studio. And then Sunday night, I got the notice that we had to move. So it's been one of those types of weeks. I know the boards say June 27th. We're rolling with June 27th, but we're actually recording on June 29th. So that should just tell you the type of week we're having. There are a lot of things that need to be tied up still. I mean, like this wire shouldn't be here. We're trying to figure that out. I'm going to get another 10-foot HDMI cord, I think, and put it in. Because the computer that runs these is now under this. It's not behind here anymore. So this project did open the door for a lot of improvements, but it's just been one of those situations. So we're going to take a break. On the other side of the break, we're going to come back. We're going to talk NASCAR, the final lap, and that'll do it. So I realized that I said in the original part of the show, Formula One was going to be after the break, but I just kept rolling. So my bad. Force of habit. All right, so we're going to take a break. On the other side of the break, NASCAR, final lap, then we're done. Be right back, guys. Welcome back live here to Racing Hotspot Week Roundup. Once again, June 27th, recording on June 29th, but we're just going to keep through it the same date. June 27th, 2017. I'm your host, Devin Poslusny, alongside my imaginary friend Bob here. Hopefully he talks a little bit more than Caitlin did. But, so let's move on here to NASCAR. Oh, wrong way. There we go. Trucks, Xfinity, and Cup. I got two bullets from each of them. Let's talk about each of them. Crafton had a hard hit in Iowa, and John Hunter Nemechek got the ultimate win. He won back, or he is back in victory lane now, which is always exciting. In the Xfinity series, they had a big accident. I'm trying to remember what that was. I think it was just three or four cars got into each other causing the big wreck. And then William Byron got the ultimate win last week or 2 weeks ago, or no, last week. He was edged out by Denny Hamlin at Michigan. And this week, for the Xfinity and Trucks, there were no Cup regulars at all in the series, in the race, because the Cup was in Sonoma. But it was one of those types of weekends that Byron was able to just excel, and it was great to see. Cup Series, stage racing on a road course. And then hard hit for Casey Kane. We're going to talk about that. But stage racing on a road course. I understand why NASCAR wanted to do stage racing, but I don't think it's worth it. I feel like you're pushing away more, or I almost said killing more fans, but pushing away more fans by doing stage racing than you are keeping them. I'll admit there were some exciting moments. Like at Martinsville. But it's not worth it in my opinion. If you're going to do stage points, okay. But don't throw a caution. Just let them go green. It's my opinion. Hard hit for Casey Kane. How many of you saw this? A good bit of you. So, the accident involving Casey Kane, there are multiple things saying he got in the dirt and he went into the wall or he got pushed by another driver. We're not going to get into that. We're going to get into the safety factor of it and the fact that he moved. When I say he moved, I mean he moved a wall. So, you have this wall that's made of K-wall. Now, for those of you who don't know what K-wall is, drive on the highway and you see the cement barriers in the middle dividing the two lanes. That's K-wall. It's really just designed as a flat edge and then the back is tapered. This way it has the surface so it doesn't move. So, this corner is K-wall. Casey Kane came in, hit the wall, and then slid up along the wall. And when he did that, he caused this wall to move. It was a sure sign that he had the momentum and he was running fast. So, people automatically went to Twitter. Why isn't there a safer barrier there? That's an unsafe section of racetrack. It's not right. Blah, blah, blah. Steve O'Donnell from NASCAR came out and I think he said it best. Some people don't realize that NASCAR is not the only series that runs at these tracks. You look at Sonoma. And Sonoma's a road course. It's a multi-purpose course. They run NASCAR. They run IndyCar. They have NHRA. They have... I'm just giving the three, I think these are the three big ones that run there. And then on top of that, you have motorcycle racing. You have Sports Car Club of America. You have, I think like Formula Open or whatever, the electric car, like not the Formula E, but the electric cars that go around the country. The course is multi-purpose. And in this section of the racetrack, there's actually, you see, there is, hold on. There is a, what is known as a rumble strip for like a corner, because this is all open. So it looks like instead of the cut through the NASCAR does, like a motorcycle, that could be that course. But I don't know, that's just an example. But the point is that... it's a multi-purpose course. So NASCAR's going to sit back and they're going to go, okay, what can we do to fix this? What can we do to make it better? And we'll go from there. But yeah, that's what I wanted to just say. Moving on to the final lap. Woof! NHRA is off till July 9th. Lucas Oil Pro Motocross runs Saturday 1 p.m. on NBC Sports Gold. Indy cars off till July 9th. Formula E's off July 15th. Formula 1's off till July 9th. Rallycross off till July 9th. WeatherTech, Sunday 10 a.m. on Fox Sports 1. Trucks are off till next Thursday, July 6th. The NASCAR Xfinity Series run Friday, 7:30 p.m. on NBCSN. And NASCAR, or Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series, runs Saturday, 7:30 p.m. on NBC. So, this week NASCAR switches coverage from Fox to NBC. Not a lot going on. It's pretty good. Looking at our calendar coming up in the next month, July is on Saturday. We have a week, one more week of shows, or 2 weeks of shows actually. And then we go to race weekend, which is pretty cool here, race weekend here in New Hampshire. So, excuse me, look forward to that. This weekend is Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s final ride at Daytona. So tune in to the coverage on NBC, 7:30 on Saturday. Formula E, their next race is July 15th, which is in New York City, which is pretty cool. Yeah, that's really all I got. So, folks, like I said, I do apologize for the blahness of this show. Like I said, it's been one of those weeks getting the studio moved from one place to another. And this is the new studio, but it's actually my bedroom. My bed is right there. My clothes are right over there in that corner. And it looks fine. It's not like my dirty underwear is right here in front of us. No. But when Dave and the Godfather come back, they're going to be fine. But that's really the room that we're in. So it's just one of those weeks that we had to move everything up. I had to basically take my room apart, organize it to be able to fit this in here. So Yeah, originally we were going to be angled this way, but then we determined this way because of the length of the room. So, it's a big undertaking, but it is what it is. So, folks, we're gonna take the next couple days off, and we'll be back in what would be a week, but now it's Thursday, June 29th, so really 3 or 4 days for our next week's show. Recapping NASCAR and Daytona, Supercross, Motocross, and Rally... sports cars. Alright? So, until we see each other, recapping that show, hopefully you guys all have a good week. Hopefully Dave will be back. Hopefully the studio will be put together even more so than it already is. But until we see each other, then, have a good week, everybody, and so long. Good night, everybody.